Hi friends, welcome to Exams Daily YouTube channel. Today in this video, I would like to share you about the latest current affairs of 24 November 2020. Before that, don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and click the bell icon for more details. The first is about national affairs. IRNSS get IMO recognition. India emerged as a fourth nation to have navigation satellite system. India has emerged as the fourth country in the world to have its dependent regional navigation satellite system recognized by IMO, which is a specialized agency of United Nations responsible for regulating shipping as a part of the worldwide radio navigation system, that is WWRNS. The IRNSS will give the accurate position information services to assist in the navigation of ships in Indian Ocean waters. The other three countries that have its navigation systems recognized by the IMO are United States, Russia, and China. The next is about Prime Minister laid foundation stone for drinking water projects in Uttar Pradesh. PM Narendra Modi laid foundation stone of rural drinking water supply projects in Miraspur and Sombhadra in Uttar Pradesh. The projects will provide tap water connections in all rural households of 2,995 villages and will benefit about 42 lakh population of these districts. The projects are planned to be completed in 24 months and the total cost of this project is ₹5,555 crore. And more about Uttar Pradesh is, the capital of Uttar Pradesh is Lucknow and the present governor is Anandiben Patel and the present chief minister is Yogi Adityanath. And the next is about international affairs. India International Cherry Blossom Festival of Shillong cancelled due to COVID-19. Cherry Blossom Festival is held annually in the month of November 2020. This festival is conducted by Meghalaya state government. This year, the festival has been cancelled due to COVID-19 pandemic situation. It is the only cherry festival being conducted in India. The cherry blossoms can be spotted across Meghalaya during this time of the year. And more about Meghalaya is, the present capital is Shillong and the governor is Satyapal Malik and the present chief minister of Meghalaya is Conrad Sangma. And the next is state affairs. Tamil Nadu state government promulgates an ordinance to ban the online games. State government of Tamil Nadu bans online game by promulgating an ordinance. The ordinance promulgated by Tamil Nadu governor Banwarilal Purohit. The ordinance further accounts for a fine of up to ₹5,000 and imprisonment of up to 6 months in case of violation of the norms. This also bans the common gaming houses and any electronic transfer of funds to distribute winnings or prize money. And more about Tamil Nadu is, the capital of Tamil Nadu is Chennai and the present chief minister is Edappadi K. Palaniswamy. And the next is about awards. Vatnayan Lifetime Achievement Award received by Union Education Minister. Union Education Minister of India is Mr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. He has received Vatnayan Lifetime Achievement Award for his immense contribution in the field of literature. Mr. Pokhriyal received this award at Vatnayan UK Facilitation Ceremony organized through video conferencing by the British Institution Group in England. Earlier, Nishank received Sahitya Bharati Award, Sahitya Gaurav Samman, Bharat Gaurav Samman, Good Governance Award by Dubai Government, etc. The next is Aditya Vikram Birla Kalashirkar Purashkar won by Nasruddin Shah. Veteran actor Nasruddin Shah has won the Aditya Vikram Birla Kalashirkar Puraskar for the year 2020. Aditya Vikram Birla Kalashkiran Puraskar won by Neil Chaudhary and Iravati Karnik also. Theatre is the central theme for this year's awards. Aditya Vikram Birla Kalashirkar Puraskar and the Kalakiran Puraskar was established in 1996. And the next is United Nations Population Award conferred for the year 2020. UNGA established Population Award for Mother Galam Shange Bhutan's Queen has been conferred with the United Nations Population Award. This award has been presented to her in the individual category of 2020 for her work on sexual health and ending gender violence. Help Age India was announced at the awards institutional lateriate. And the next is about rankings and index. EIU's worldwide cost of living index, topped by Hong Kong, Paris and Swiss. EIU's worldwide cost of living index, topped by Hong Kong, Paris and Swiss. The Economist Intelligence Unit, that is EIU, has published the biannual worldwide cost of living report of the world's most expensive cities in 2020. In the index, Hong Kong, Paris and Swiss topped the chart with 103 points each. This report was generated based on their cost of living. And the next is about summits and conferences. President Ramnath Kovind to inaugurate 18th All India Presiding Officers Conference on November 25. President Ramnath Kovind to inaugurate 18th All India Presiding Officers Conference on November 25. President of India, Sri Ramnath Kovind, will inaugurate 18th All India Presiding Officers Conference. The conference was scheduled on November 25. The theme of this year's conference is Harmonious Coordination of Legislative, Executive and Judiciary Key to a Vibrant Democracy. On 26th November, which is celebrated as Constitution Day, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will address the valedictory session of the conference. And the next is India to host G20 Summit in 2023, Brazil in 2024. India will host the G20 Summit in 2023. Recently, the G20 summit was hosted by Russia. Brazil will conduct the summit in 2024. The main focus of this was on resilient, inclusive and sustainable recovery from COVID-19 crisis. The last G20 summit was held in March 2020. In G20 summit, Indian side was presented by Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi. The next is Malaysia host APEC summit virtually through video conferencing. The Asian Pacific Economic Cooperation was hosted by Malaysia on November 20, 2020. The next APEC meeting is being hosted by New Zealand. On the summit, the members then committed towards free and open trade and investment. The Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation is an intergovernmental forum for 21 member economies in the Pacific Rim that promotes free trade throughout the Asia Pacific region. And more about this summit is the headquarters of the summit is located in Singapore and the founder is Bob Hawkway and it was founded on November 1989. The next is about defense news. Indian Navy host Simbex 20 exercise in Andaman, bilateral maritime exercise between India and Singapore. Indian Navy is conducting bilateral maritime exercise between India and Singapore named Simbex 20. The exercise is being held in Andaman Sea. The exercise is first established at 1994. The Simbex series of exercises between the Indian Navy and Republic of Singapore Navy. This exercise aimed at enhancing mutual interoperability and imbibing best practices from each other. And more about Indian Navy is, the Chief of the Naval Staff is Admiral Karambir Singh and the Deputy Chief of the Naval Staff is Vice Admiral M.S. Pawar. And it was founded on 26 January 1950. And the next is sports news. ATP Finals 2020 concludes. Daniil Medvedev defeats Dominic Thiem. Russian tennis player Daniil Medvedev defeated Austria's Dominic Thiem to win ATP Tour Finals, the biggest title of his career. Notably, Medvedev became the first Russian to win the title since Nikolay Davydenko, who won London's first edition in 2009. And the next is about important days. National Pharmacy Week observed in India. 59th National Pharmacy Week was held in India from November 16, 2020 to November 22, 2020. This week was observed by the Indian Pharmaceutical Association in collaboration with Delhi Pharmaceutical Trust. Theme for the 2020 years is Pharmacist Frontline Health Professionals. Every year, the Indian Pharmaceutical Association has been observing the National Pharmacy Week on the third week of November. And that's it for today's current affairs. And if you want to know more about this current affairs, we have given the link in description box so that you can get further reference also. And if you like this video and if you think this video is very useful for you, don't forget to like, comment and share our video, and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and click the bell icon for daily updates of this current affairs. Thank you.